Welcome to class 5 of Indian Financial System, and in this we are going to learn about the money market, so which is one part of the financial market. So what do you understand with the money market? The money market is one of the pillars of the global financial system, and we all know that. So it involves overnight swaps of vast amount of money between the banks and the government. The majority of money market transactions are wholesale transactions, so that takes place between the financial institutions and the company. So money market, as we know, money market refers to the market where the money are highly liquid marketable securities that are bought and sold having a maturity period of year or less than a year. So it says it has a high liquidity, which means the instruments in the money market or the securities in the money market can easily be converted into cash. So that is within 1 year. So we can say money market is highly liquidable. Then the money market refers to trading a very short-term debt investments at a wholesale level. It involves large volume of trade between the institutions and the traders at the retail level. So it includes money market mutual funds bought by the individual investors and money market accounts opened by the customers. So these all are the cases. The money market is characterized by high degree of safety and relatively low rate of returns. Okay, so money market is a market where the short term things are bought and sold, or we can say the money market refers to the market which has high liquidity, very safety, short term debt securities. Because of these attributes, they are often seen, and we can say the cash equivalents that can be interchangeable for money at a short notice. Okay, so we can ask now why the money market is important. So before going to that, we'll go through the definition. So as per the RBI definition, they say a market for a short-term financial assets that are closely substitute for money facilitates the exchange of money in a primary and secondary market. The money market is a mechanism that deals with the lending and borrowing of short-term funds, so that are within 1 year. So why money market is important, right? So money market is a crucial for smooth functioning of modern financial economy. So it allows the savers to lend money to those who are in need of short-term loans and allocates the capital towards its most productive uses. So these loans, often made overnight or for a matter of days, a week, are needed by the government, corporations or the companies and the bank in order to meet their near terms obligations or regulatory requirements. At the same time, allows those with the excess cash on hand to earn the interest. So what may be the downsides or disadvantages of the money market? So because they are virtually risk free, money market investments also come with a very low interest rate. So risk is less, interest is also less. So often the risk-free rate of return. As a result, so they will not provide the substantial capital gain or investment growth compared to the riskier assets like your bond or stock which is there. So sometimes, or the money market, so like accounts like certificate of deposits, furthermore you can lock your money up until it matures, so which can range for months to year. Okay, so the next we are going to study is functions. So I forgot to mention the title here, functions of money market. So the functions of money market. So money market contributes to the economic stability. and development of the country. So by providing what? By providing the short-term liquidity to the government, commercial bank and other large organizations. So what investors do? Investors with the excess money that they do not need can invest it in a money market and they can earn interest out of that. There are some functions, or we can say a role. So like financing trading. So it is mentioned here, the money market provides the financing to the local and international traders who are in urgent need of short-term funds. So it provides the facility to discount the bill of exchange, and this provides immediate financing to pay for goods and services. So international traders benefit from the acceptance house and the discount markets. So the money market also makes fund available for other units of the economy, such as your agriculture and small scale industries. The next is your central bank policy. So what is this central bank policy? So central bank policy says that it guides for the monetary policy of the country and taking measures to ensure a healthy financial system. So through money market, the central government can perform its policy making function efficiently. For example, the short-term interest rates in the money market represents prevailing condition in the banking industry and can guide the central bank in developing an appropriate interest rate policy. So also the integrated money markets help the central bank to influence the sub-market and implement its monetary policy objectives. Okay, then the next it says growth of industries. So the money market provides an easy way or avenue where businessmen or the business can obtain short-term loan to finance their working capital needs. So due to the large volume of transaction, business may experience cash shortages relating to buying raw materials, paying employees or meeting other short-term expenses. So through commercial papers and financial bills, so they can easily borrow money on a short-term basis. So although money markets do not provide large or long-term loans, so it influences the capital market and can also help the business to obtain the long-term financing. The capital market benchmarks are there. So its interest rates, so which are based on the prevailing interest rate in the money market. The next we can see the commercial banks self-sufficiency. Commercial banks self-sufficiency. So what is this commercial bank self-sufficiency? So it is given. The money market provides commercial banks with a ready market. So it provides the commercial banks with a ready market, where they can invest their excess reserves to earn interest while maintaining liquidity. So liquidity is also there. So they are also going to get the interest rate. So benefits the both, right? The next, it says short-term investments such as bills of exchange can easily be converted into cash to support the investors or the customer's withdrawal, right? Which are going to support the customer's withdrawal. So when the liquidity problems are there, so they can borrow from the money market. Suppose they are afraid of facing the liquidity, you are bothered about the liquidity. So what you do? You are going to borrow from money market on a short-term basis as an alternative to borrowing from the central bank. So the advantage of this is that the money market may charge lower interest rate on a shorter term loan. Okay, so then the central bank typically does. So these are the functions or role of your commercial bank, sorry, money market. And in the next class, we are going to deal with the instruments of money market. Thank you.